బ్రహ్మవిద్యా సంప్రదాయ కర్తృభ్యో వంశ ఋషభ్యో మహద్భ్యో నమో గురుభ్యః సర్వోపప్లవరహిత ప్రజ్ఞాన ఘన ప్రత్యగర్థో బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి సోహమస్మి బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి. ఓం ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైక పాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుహే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైటీ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర బెస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పెరిటీ, హెల్త్, వెల్త్ అండ్ ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ విత్ పూర్ణ లక్ష్మీ కటాక్షం టు యూ అండ్ యువర్ ఎంటైర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్ అండ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్ టు. లెట్ అస్ బిగిన్ భగవద్గీత 4th chapter verse number 13. శ్రీ భగవాన్ ఉవాచ చాతుర్వర్ణ్యం మయా సృష్టం గుణకర్మ విభాగశః తస్య కర్తారమపి మాం విద్య కర్తారమవ్యయం. భగవాన్ కృష్ణ ఇస్ బ్రింగింగ్ 4 varnas హ్యావ్ బీన్ ఎస్టాబ్లిష్డ్ బై మీ. యాజ్ వి బిగన్ ఇన్ ద లాస్ట్ సెషన్ ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్, బిఫోర్ ఎంటరింగ్ ఇన్ టు దిస్ వర్డ్స్ జస్ట్ వీ విల్ హ్యావ్ అ స్మాల్ అనాలిసిస్, బికాస్ దాట్ అనాలిసిస్ విల్ హెల్ప్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ దిస్ వర్డ్స్ వెల్. ఆయుర్వేద, ది ఆయుర్వేద ఇస్ ద బూన్ ఫర్ అవర్ సొసైటీ విచ్ ఈస్ ఎగ్జిస్టింగ్ ఇన్ ద వేద యాజ్ ద పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఇట్. దిస్ ఆయుర్వేద డివైడ్స్ ద బాడీస్ నేచర్ ఇన్ టు 3 aspects ఎవ్రీ వన్ ఆఫ్ అస్ ఆర్ అవేర్. We call it the Vata, Pitta, Kapha. The Vata Sharira, it has got its own way, its own nature, its own nature to get disease, its own way to get involved with activity. A Vata Sharira person, so always affected by air-related, Vayu-related problem. This Pitta Sharira, so that person's mind is not calm. It is affected by Ushna related, that Ushna means heat related disease. His mind also is endowed with lots of emotions. This Kapha related, the Kapha related person always, you know, he is achieved by Shita related disease. Shita means cold related, Kapha related diseases. So this category is to give welfare for the humanity. We accept it. This the acceptance, when we adapt ourselves, we will definitely come out of any disease. In the same way, now the blood group also divided in our medical science. So this is a great invention. So when you know about your blood group, in every driving license we put the blood group. So that group will help for the doctor to treat you at proper time, proper way to get, you know, nourished. We call it A positive, O positive, B positive, AB positive. And this 4 category also can be given negative. A negative, O negative, B negative, AB negative. So this category, so we cannot fight for that. How can you have the categorized this blood? This is nonsense. Nobody asks the questions. Because we know the benefit by this deficiency. Like, so this Vata, Pitta, Kapha, so it is not only the nature of the body, is the nature of even our psychological system. Because Vata Sharira, so always affected by air related, means Vayu related disease, that person, when he works in different way. This Pitta related person always, you know, becoming irritated nature, angry bird, like the tendency is always change. This cold related person, you know, this Kapha related person always silent. He is not heated up. Always silent. He is also sometimes cold blooded. Now, your guna characteristic is established by your nature of physical system. And your psychological system also established by physical system. Physical system is established by psychological system. So that, you know, when you sit for meditation, if you are a Vayu related person, means a Vata person, so you have the mind, so that mind is endowed with so many oscillations, fluctuated like anything. So these connections are given for the humanity to come out of any kinds of problem, whether it is physical or psychological or something, the problem outside. So that great boons must be accepted, adapted in order to nourish our life, the blood group also like that. So now Bhagavan Krishna, he gives four varnas, their problem begins. So there is nothing problem. It's not decided by the birth, again and again you study there. No one word is available, that which says by birth. Then you may have the questions. Then why should we consider by birth Brahmanas and Brahmanas, Vaishyas and Vaishya, and Kshatriyas and Kshatriya? See, one thing. First, let us understand the words. Then you yourself will accept, yes, yes. So it's of course. Because finding the nature, judging the nature, understanding one's own nature is very difficult. If I ask you what the natures you want, you may say something that may go wrong, because the people nearby you, they know very well, you know, whatever you know about you. This judging ourselves is very difficult job, my dear. Now here says, a soul, an individual who always gives priority to Lord Ishvara, who could have the Shraddha, who could have the belief on the Almighty, though Almighty is not seen. So when he thinks about Tirupati Balaji, so he becomes a great devotee. He could see everywhere the Balaji itself. I know a person who has become a very big successful businessman. So he has taken Balaji as a partner. He considers he is alive. So every time when he wants to make a decision, he goes to Tirupati and he has the darshan. After darshan, he sits in the campus of the temple. There he decides. So he considers Balaji is alive. That Shraddha. So that Shraddha, when you have about Almighty, when you could accept Vedas as the valid pramanas. You know, pramana means what? Valid, evident. When you see bilirubin high in your blood, when you go and take the blood test, so they will say that your bilirubin is high. So it means what? You consider that person is affected by jaundice. The jaundice person, bilirubin should be high. This is a valid pramana, physical pramana. So like that, Veda is the pramana for Surga, Veda is the pramana for Naraka, Veda is the pramana for Karma Phala, Papa, Punya. So Veda says about myself, I have to believe, it's not that belief is 50-50, no, 100% belief. This is what known as Shraddha. Shraddhavan Labhate Jnanam. Veda says the moti is done pranapratishtha. That pranapratishtha means we call it installation. So not installation, we call it consecration. This installation, consecration, pranapratishtha, if it is done, very much Lord is available there. So believe, to accept, in order to believe, you need to have the acceptance. So that you have the ability to give the priority, pradhanatva, to Vedas. And you don't have the doubt of Vedas. And you don't have money, desire, and you don't wish to have power. You are, for you, they are nothing. Name and fame and power and money and relations. So you just stick with Vedas and you are able to do, follow what Veda says. So there is a text called Sadhana Panchakam. Vedo nityam adhiyatam taduditam karma svanuthiyatam tene sasya vidhiyatam apachiteh kamye matisthyajyatam. See, he says Vedo nityam adhiyatam. He has adapted Vedas as a lifestyle. He has become like a Veda Purushaha, and not only that, he considers all people are equal. Okay, that person means that individuality, that buddhi, that intellect is considered as a Brahmana buddhi. So when you give supreme knowledge to him, so he won't be endowed with selfishness. He will be working with selflessness. He will give to entire universe without any bhedaha. So he considers all the creatures are equal. Therefore, the Brahmatmaikya Jnanam is valued by a Brahmana. Who values the Brahma Vidya, he becomes Brahmana. This is given example by the lineage parampara. The second one, a mind, a buddhi, which gives a valid, solid pramana to dharma. For him, he cannot tolerate if anything is done against dharma. He may sacrifice his life for that to protect dharma, but he wishes to have the power, he wishes to have the name and fame. For him, the life is nothing but glorious. So for him, is a fight is the nature. So he is ready to argue, he is ready to establish dharma, and also he doesn't have money desire. He doesn't wish to have money. He doesn't even to have bank balance, because he is not leaning on those, depending on those deadly materials. He is parakramavan, courageous person. So that individual intellect can be called kshatriya, and he won't have the bank balance because he don't have fear. He won't have death fear. He doesn't have any fear. Then another one, mind, that intellectual, so which is endowed with expansion. Already we have seen long back. So whatever you give, he will expand like anything. And he wishes to have name and fame and wishes on that. So when he worships with lots of gold, coin, and lots of flowers. He celebrates the puja in great way, Vaishya Buddhi, nothing wrong with that. Then Shudra. Shudra is the person who is a Karma Yogi. So wherever the work is to be done physically, he stands there. He gets done everything in solid way. All the work and nourishment, people should depend on him. See, other people should depend on the buddhi, which is Shudra. It knows how to work. It knows how to establish any kind of assignment given. He will be very successful person. And he also studies Puranas, Vedas, and he also is sticking with lots of Pauranika way. These four categories is available in the human body, mind and sense complex. So now we have to find what the nature we are, what the nature our system has. Now, so if we make the decision wrongly against our system, we will be in the chaos. Therefore, life is nothing but making the decision. Every second you have to make the decision. So decision making alone the life, I can say in that way. When you open the small shop, that small shop can be a big mall because of your decision. So when you begin a small business, so it should expand only because of your decision. So your mind and buddhi should have decision making capacity. So when you make the decision, your field, whether you are selecting your field, your partner, your lifestyle, your house to live, all of them are in the form of decision. Whatever you eat, that also should be decided by you. Everything is nothing but decision. Now, if you know what the nature you want, if you know from the birth what the nature, so according to which norms Vedas have been described, you have to analyze about yourself. Then you can select the field according to that. Once you select the field according to that, your system also will get inner growth. At the same time, you can be also very, very much successful person in outside world. Now, so all the successful person, you go and see, I know a person who is a billionaire, but he wants to, you know, the stitch cloth, but his field is something other than this field. So he wants to stitch the cloth. He stitches himself. I asked, why are you doing this? Then you need not to get it done this. He says, no, this is Atma Tripti. This is what my nature is. I make so many varieties of design, but so my father's job I adapted, but I'm working in there. But when I do this, I feel myself relaxed. So that selecting the field. So now we study so much. We do research on so many things, but not knowing our nature. You have to fix your field and your nature. So it has to be aligned with, or it has to be on one path, one line. Then what? Definitely your life will be converted as the heaven. You can smash all the hellly things from your life. That is what the boon of this category. Now we will come to other point. Tasya kartaram api mam. He says, I am the karta. I am the karta means what? I only established this. But he says, I am a karta too. I am a karta. We will accept one aspect. I am the karta. Okay. Other aspects, he says in the next words. So I am the akarta. Let us see the next words. We will get that. I am the akarta means I am not the karta. I am not the author. I am not the creator. Now we will read it. Namam karmani limpanti. Name karma phale spruha. Iti mam yo bhijanati. Karma bhirna sabadhyate. I am not the karta because I am not affected by karma phala. Why? You look at sun, you look at the earth which always revolving and rotating the himself and going around the sun. It doesn't have kartrutva. Where there is no kartrutva, so only the intention is for welfare for the humanity, then that can be the karma which is purified, called loka sangraha. So Bhagavan Krishna says, I create, no doubt in it, but I don't have kartrutva. So this part has to be understood by whoever discusses on the topic. So sun rises, nobody is putting the or filing the case against the sun. How can it rise every day? So one day sun is not seen, nobody can blame it because sun is doing loka sangraha. So river also the same way. So river flows as the loka sangraha, kalyanarthe, and the air, rain, everything is going. That's what the nature is like. This Bhagavan has become the one with the nature. So when he created that creation, the division is not to confuse us, the division to help us. We have to understand there is no superiority, there is no inferiority involved in the category. Now I am coming to the point. So why then we just confirm by birth? That's what, you know, something went wrong in between. So guna and karma, according to his nature, according to his karma field, so selected by his decision with the understanding about himself. Now a person who wants to be a pujari, he wants to be a worshipper like Ramakrishna. So Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, who was worshipping La Kali, goddess Kali. So that Kali worship is the, you know, his life. Without seeing her, he cannot be there. Like Annamacharya. So this person, he wants to be a worshipper in the temple. But his father, who was also Brahmin, he says that go and earn money. And he went, joined in the work. He got succeed in IIT and he is working in US. Now what happened? Suddenly one day he called me. I don't find my life in this. I feel hell, Swamiji. What should I do? So then I said, don't worry. You learn Veda from there. You fix a Veda party. You can learn Veda. Now he is learning Veda. Though he is in different field, now he is doing what to be done. So though he may not, you know, he may not convert himself as a pujari, but he can worship. That worship is the nature. Now see, selecting the field. That is what I said, guna and karma, we have to go according to that. From there, with an understanding, we can cross the karma phala. That's what the nature is. Now, vidhi akartaram avyayam, avyayam akartaram aham vidhi. I am the non-doer. Because whatever I do like a sun god. I do like a river. I do like a rain. I do like a clouds. They do only welfare. When you have that Brahmajnanam, whatever the karma you produce, that will be also considered like that alone, known as Loka Sangraham. So now he has created for Loka Sangraham, means so welfare for the society. But he is not attached. He doesn't have any ego. Because when you are endowed with ego, so this fruit, result also goes to you. So when you are endowed with Brahma Jnana, you don't see the creature other than you. You will do only welfare for that. This is what the definition traditionally. So this is the brief explanation which we have seen. So if we have the time in future, we will have the elaborate discussion why one should judge the nature. Let it be instinct way, like a Westerner. So that can be not like a debate. It can be like a samvada. So debate is not the samvada. Samvada is a discussion. So which is in the form of inquiry. So which is the best? That is the discussion. That is the inquiry. The debate won't help on this subject. So now he says, Namam karmani limpanti, name karma phale spruha. So I am doing that, but as though I am doing, but I don't have the desire on the karma phala. So that, because of that, the karma phala won't affect me. Iti mam yo bhijanati, karma bhi na sabadhyate. If anybody understands me as the akarta, he will also get rid of kartrutva. Kartrutva means doership. He will also get rid of it. Now you see, so when you realize Bhagavan as akarta, you will also become akarta. Next words, evam yatva kritam karma purvairapi mumukshabihi kuru karmaiva tasmatvam purvaih purvataram kritam. Evam yatva kritam karma purvaihi purvaihi mumukshubihi api evam yatva karmam kritam. So our forefather also performed the karma with the same understanding like which I've told in the last verses. You just follow as it is. Kuru karma iva tasmatvam. Therefore you just follow the same methodology. You can keep yourself away. You can save yourself from karma phala. The secret is revealed. Now very important words in the fourth chapter. So the previous chapter was important subject, but this is the essence of fourth chapter. This words, let us read. Kim karma kima karmeti kavayopyatra mohitaha tatte karma pravakshyami yajnyatva mokshase shubhata. This word is not as a teaching. It's not a like a statement. This is a formula. The formula is explained. When somebody understands that I am nothing but Brahman, I am one with God, when he understands the God, what the chemical changes will happen. I'm not talking about physically. So what the changes will take place in his understanding, in his buddhi, inside of him. So will he be a normal person, or will he have a different understanding? Will he become a mystic person? That's what is told here. He just gives a glimpse of it. Arjuna, it's very difficult to be with the karma, because when you perform the karma, you have to have the doership. You cannot deny it, but you should not get connected with that doership. So in order to not to get connected with that doership, you should be very much aware. It's very difficult, isn't it? Okay. So you make the pot. Okay. Not pot. You go and make idli, dosa, sambar. You make the sambar. You cook the sambar. While cooking the sambar, automatically you will have that I am the doer. I am making sambar, isn't it? Now, you have to work. When you have the doership, you just enjoy the doer which is experienced there. So I am making sambar, that I am is ahankara, I am an observer of the I which is endowed with the doership. It means what? I am making sambar, I am making sambar for the Nivedya, Lord Parameshwara, but I am not the maker. My ahankara which is endowed with body, mind, eye and sense complex, I am just observing that ahankara. You can become as the witness. So when you become witness, when you connect with that witness, this ahankara will lose to produce the karma. Because ahankara creates karma phala. That it may be very difficult. So, you know, whenever I begin a shloka and I stop, you will see tomorrow, you become little bit irritated. You know, this Swami, you know, always stops in a important place and he is not taking further. Now, I have given brief about that verse, but I will elaborate in the next session. What is karma? What is akarma? That is the topic. This is the essence of the fourth chapter. We will study it in the next session. See you. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.